NPPT, PWM, series, versus parallel. What happens when you shut one down?
So I've got another cool demo for you. I've got the boys from Enerdrive here again. Dave's helped me out. This time we're on Stradbroke Island instead of Fraser, so it's a hard life, I know. This time, solar panels. So this is sort of simulating what we've got on the roof of our van. We've got the off-grid lithium battery system in the van. I'll drop the link in the post so you can check out that vid in the install. But we've got 600 watts of solar on the roof, big inverter, and a lithium watt pack battery inside that runs the whole show. What we got here is we've got four 100 watt panels, same brand as these, just 50 watts less, but we're going to show you the output of them and through two different controllers. So to sort of, we've had a lot of questions about why haven't we used an MPPT controller in our setup, because we've got a PWM. Well, this will show you why, and we'll also show you what happens when you put a bit of shade over the panels or you block one off. So it's really hard. I know it sounds fantastic to have a massive solar array on the roof of your van, but sometimes you just might think you're not really getting the full potential out of it. But this will show you exactly how it works and why maybe your amperage is down a bit, but it's no fault of the solar panels. It's just how they work and the conditions that we live in and caravan in. So check this out. The panels are all hooked up. So the other thing we're going to show you is series connection and paralleling, right? So ours are paralleled on the roof because that's the way to go. But you can also series them, but we'll show you the difference and why you should and shouldn't do them through the controllers. So at the moment, the four panels, two separate banks, they're in parallel and they're running through a separate shunt each into this e-power lithium 200 amp hour battery. So also give you a hot tip. This is what's going to go in our new build when we team up with Norwelt and Pro Touring Concepts and Enerdrive. We're going to have a schmick-ass canopy that's going to be decked out with this gear. So over here we've got the PWM controller, and here we've got an MPPT controller, and these two are two digital readouts, the e-power gauges that'll tell us exactly how much amperage is going in. So quick run here now, this is the MPPT, it's got 10.4 amps going in, 10.3. This is the PWM, we got 10, just under 10 amps going in. So there's really maybe a 0.2, 0.3 of an amp difference out of 200 watts of solar from an MPPT to a PWM. Now, for the price point, I know the controller in my van, the TriStar 45 amper, it isn't this one, but it's about $380, right? And for a MPPT controller, it's about $1,080. So you're paying $700 for, 0.2 of an amp per 200 watts. So is that really worth it? I reckon you're probably better off grabbing another panel or a portable panel and following the sun than spending the money on an MPPT controller. So the good purpose of MPPT is that it will work at the earlier in the day and later in the day because it can convert that voltage at lower angles of the sun and start charging earlier and later. The PWM won't do that, but look at it, you're only missing like 0.2 of an amp. Like, is it really going to be worth it? So that's what that does, right? Now what we're going to do, I'll show you, I'll put a bit of shade over these panels and you can watch the output drop. So it's really surprised me as to how much it actually affects the output of the panel. I always thought that if you just covered them up a bit, you just drop an amp or two out of your output. It's actually a lot more than that. So I'm going to borrow Dave's hat, this one here. If you watch this, all I'm going to do is cover up one section of this panel and the gauge will go from 10 amps to about 5, because it will literally just cut the output of this. So there's our gauge there, down to 4.9 amps. Dave can hold it there and I'll just take the hat off. Hat's off, back up the 10 amps. So what it's doing, like I'm only covering up one panel, one little square of that panel, and it's actually isolating it or cutting out the output of that whole 100 amp panel. So pretty crazy, hey. I never thought that. I thought it would just drop it a little bit, but take it off, back up to full amperage. Now, the other thing I'll do, I'll grab a tree branch because it'll show you, like when we've got a bit of shade, like on the roof up here, it'll show you what it does. It doesn't exactly cut it out, but it does reduce it. Now, the problem we've got with solar panels on the roof of caravans, and ours included, is you've got roof hatches, you've got TV antennas, you've got air conditioning units, and all those things cast a shadow. Like, we're lucky today that the sun is pretty much directly on top of us, so we've got full output, and I'm getting about close to 30 amps out of the panels on my roof. But How often does that happen? The sun's always at a bit of a different angle, so you're always going to cop a bit of shade over a panel, and it only takes to cover that one square with full shade, there's your panel gone. So I'll grab this tree branch and I'll show you what it does. So tree branch, here we go. This is like where we're parked at the moment. If I cover that panel up there, you should see that gauge start to drop in amperage. It's going down. And then if I move it closer and down lower, it should go down. And then move the branch away altogether, amperage goes back up. So it doesn't take much to really mess with the output of your panels. So what we're going to do now is show you in series what happens and what are the benefits of having parallel over series. Righto, so we've switched these over to series now, so just to change a couple of leads. What we're going to do is show you what happens when you cover it up, same as parallel. What will happen is that we'll lose the whole array, not just one panel like parallel. So here's the gauge, got 10.5 amps going in, should be able to see that. I'll just cover up one square of this panel and then bang, we lose our whole array of solar and no amps going into the battery. We pull the hat off, bang, back up to 10 amps. So there's the main reason not to hook your panels up in series, because any sort of shade, any sort of coverage, you're going to lose the whole lot. So what we'll also show you over here, so between the PWM and the MPPT, there's no point running series panels into a PWM because they just won't work. You'll only get half the output. That doesn't run on 24 volt. You'll have to run it on MPPT. But like I've just shown you, is there really any point? Run parallel panels through a PWM, cheaper for the controller, and it works a treat. Like I said, can never get 100% efficiency unless you've got the perfect conditions, which you're not gonna have really. Maybe 2% of your caravanning life, you'll get perfect solar conditions. Most of the time, it's gonna be like this, few trees, hatches, shade, whatever. So gear up like this, parallel, good controller, good quality glass panels, and good batteries, you should be able to power yourself up, no dramas. If you want any more info, Dave's here with me and he's done a really good informative one, talking a bit more about how they all work properly. He's a lot more technical minded than I am. So I'll drop the link into the post for that. But cheers guys, any questions, drop them in the comments. Happy to help out where I can.